lot of great old stuff, including some old Sabbath stuff. Plus DAD, plus the crew, Sabotage, Bonham, LA Guns, who are just getting ready to go out on the road. We've got Iron Maiden. We've got the Angels, which used to be called Angel City, but now they're called the Angels. We've got Havana Black. We've got some older stuff from Judas Priest. And a whole lot more. Plus, guests on tonight's show will be Babylon AD and DRI. And we've got the Metal Detector with reports on Hurricane Alice and White Zombie. And you're going to find out what's going on with Ted Nugent, with Rat and the Bullet Boys. And debut videos from Vane and Shotgun Messiah. But first, here's Michael Monroe. You know, he's got his solo album out. And right now in Japan, he's huge. Hanoi Rock, which of course was his earlier band, was real big in Japan. And did okay here. Now with this album, hopefully he'll break in the States. It's kind of a good pop song, and I like it a lot, and I think you will too. Here is Michael Monroe. This was filmed in Japan on his last tour there. This is The Man with No Eyes. I don't know the truth, I love doing the Headbangers Ball. This is very much fun for me. Not only do I get to watch great songs, I get to interview some very cool people. Now, there were two people I always wanted to interview. When I went to school, my idols were Alice Cooper, which I've already got to interview, and Ted Nugent. And I got to interview Ted Nugent. It was at that KNEC anniversary party they had at Santa Monica Civic a couple weeks back. Well, here is me speaking to one of my idols, Ted Nugent. Light, camera, auction. Auction. One of the things that I do like about this job is I get to interview one of my idols.
Ricky!
And I couldn't find one, but here's Ted Nugent.
It's Ricky!
So Ted, why don't you tell us you're working at... Ted, you're working on a rock and roll show.
Well, it's not really new. It's rock and roll. It's been around for a long time, Rico. No, I have been checking out some new stuff with some buddies of mine. You know, I've known Tommy Shaw from Styx, and he needed help. He needed to go to the Ted Nugent halfway house for wounded whoopers. No, actually, Tommy and I have been talking for years, and Jack Blades and I have known each other for a long time.
From Night Ranger?
Yeah, and I've always appreciated some of their more thrusting maneuvers. I like thrust. And I am the crust of the thrust, and it's a must that I will bust the crust. And the new project is called...
The project is called The Damn Yankees. Actually, it was The Yankees, and they invited me and it became The Damn Yankees. And I'm really proud of the project. It's like rhythm and blues, rock and roll with a lot of attitude. And
these guys' vocals, man, there's a blend that, like, it really pisses me off. I'm proud of these guys. But it's like Guitars from Hell with this great vocal thing, and Ron Nevis is producing, and The Damn Yankees record will be out, I think, in mid-March on Warner Brothers. It'll be a wonderful day in America, and it's cool, man. I can't wait. 1990 should be fun and games, my specialty.
Well, always at a loss for words, Mr. Ted Nugent, and now back to New York. And have you noticed how much Ted slowed down through the years and became so shy? Here's an L.A. band which used to have members of Rough Cut in it, including the drummer Dive. That's how he talks. If you ever go up to Sam, you say, "Hi, Dive." And this is Jailhouse with Please Come Back.
Now listen up, gentlemen. What does it take to make a truly world-class video? I'll tell you what it takes. It takes classy automobiles and motorcycles and gorgeous sexy women. It takes a certain ambiance to make that special look, you know, hair, makeup, expensive flashy wardrobe, mirror balls. You know what I'm talking about. These are the things I'm going to create for you. Now there'll be three cameras, camera A, camera B, and of course camera C. Are we happy? Gentlemen, is there some sort of a problem?
Just roll the camera.
Without my mind, I can't. Now that's how you make a rock video.
Yeah.
Metal Detector, New York's White Zombie, have just unleashed a new EP. It's called The God of Thunder, and it follows last year's album, Make Them Die Slowly. It features a re-recording of that album's Love Razor, which was on the previous one, and it's now on this one again, and it's got a heavy cover of the old Kiss tune, God of Thunder. White Zombie's ghoulish sound has been described as chaos metal with horror movie-inspired lyrics backed by heavy power riffs. They just came off a European tour and plan on playing some East Coast dates real soon, so some of you will be able to experience their ghoulish rock live in your face. Hurricane Alice is getting ready to blow into record stores. Their debut album is called Tear the House Down. The band headed into the studio last spring with producer Tom Panunzio, and he's worked in the past with Iggy Pop and U2. And according to guitarist Dan Gill, Hurricane Alice is the ultimate party band. Dan has followed in the footsteps, or guitar straps as you might say, of Steve Vai and Kirk Hammett by studying with the great guitarist Joe Satriani. Now, as we exit from the Metal Detector into a video from DAD, this is Girl Nation. From Babylon AD here right now, but the couch is empty and they're not here, and I understand they are on the phone. Can you hear me?
We can hear you.
Who is this?
This is Rob.
Rob from Babylon AD, where are you?
We're in the frozen tundra.
Of?
The Great White North, man.
Of?
We're up in Toronto.
Why are you in Toronto and you're not here?
Well, here's the story. We were supposed to be there, and we went to the airport, like a normal person would do. Once we get on our plane, boom, it's canceled. So we try to reroute another airline, you know, another flight, boom, that gets canceled. We can't even get to our next gig.
Where is your next? So you guys supposed to be playing tonight?
Yeah, we're supposed to be in Detroit tonight, and
you're in Toronto now?
We're in Toronto now.
So how are you going to make it from Toronto to Detroit?
We might have to hitchhike. I don't know, man.
So if any of you guys see some of the Babylon AD guys outside, give them a ride.
Give us a ride, please. We'll give you a buck or two. You know, we'll pay for gas.
Okay. Now, real quick. The name Babylon AD, mm-hmm. Kind of like a decadent sort of name. How did you guys come up with that name? I know you get asked that question all the time.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's pretty basic, actually. It's like the definition of Babylon is that any large city of wickedness and sin and decadence, like you said.
Like Toronto?
Like Toronto. Like any major metropolitan city. And we just actually came from Derek, our lead singer, took a trip to New York. And the first time he ever went there, he got up out of the subway train and looked around and said, "Man, this is, look at this, this is just, it's going down, you know, it's all dirty, homeless people, moms, and it was just like Babylon." So that's where that came from. No, just to bring it to more modern day kind of feel, you know.
Now, can you guys just stay warm, some videos, and then we want to talk to you more. So you guys got a lot of quarters?
We got many rolls of quarters.
Okay. Well, hold on to the quarters, and we're going to play some videos right now. We're going to be playing Sabotage with Gutter Ballet, and we'll talk to you in a little bit, okay?
See ya.
So wrong.
Jennifer is empty. Jennifer, of course, being our couch. But a reasonable facsimile of the guys from Babylon AD are on it. But are you still there in the Toronto airport?
Yeah, we're here. We're the invisible people on the couch, though, you know?
And you're putting this entire fund bill on your record company's credit card, correct?
Exactly.
Good. That's good to hear.
We're sending it to Milli Vanilli.
Oh, good. They can afford it. Okay, anyways, a few minutes ago, we just saw your video for Bango the Bells, kind of a sort of death row game show meets Wheel of Fortune.
Yeah, there you go, something like that.
Mm-hmm. What was the whole idea about that?
Well, you know, we got a script and we read it and we thought it was, you know, pretty cool, and we threw in some ideas of our own, you know, wanted to get more sinister characters to it, sort of like a neo-futurism 1984 type of thing or something, you know, and the record company and the director thought it was going to be pretty cool to have a game show type of thing. And
so you definitely got say on this video, right?
We got a little bit of say, you know, enough to make the characters a little bit more in-depth, a little bit more, I don't know what you'd call it, a little bit more evil or something, or a little bit more like the band, you know what I mean? A little bit more darker, you know?
Mm-hmm. Are you real happy with the way it turned out? Because it looks great.
Yeah, you know, I'm fairly happy. I think I would be lying to you if I said I was 100% happy, but I think...
But are you ever 100% happy?
No, that's what I was going to say. You know, any artist that's going to sit there and tell you that they got the greatest video in the world is going to be lying because... there's something in there that they don't like, you know what I mean?
Right. Now, you guys have a pretty wide variation of influences, right?
Oh, yeah.
Like, what are some of the types of music you guys listen to?
Well, you know, like, I listen to, a lot of old stuff, like Al Green and Marvin Gaye and...
And Motown sound.
Yeah, a lot of Motown stuff, you know, but then again, you know, at the same time, I grew up on, you know, stuff like Aerosmith and AC/DC, UFO, you know, Scorpions, stuff like that, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So, pretty much the whole band grew up in the same type of Bay Area, Oakland scene, you know, where it's black and white, you know what I mean?
Now, I know you guys are from the Bay Area, Oakland scene, where right now thrash and speed metal is really big out there. Was it hard coming from that scene, not really being part of the thrash heavy metal scene?
No, not really, man, because it's weird. It's in sections up there, you know? There's one section plays the thrash metal stuff, one section, you know, like San Francisco has more like a Vane type of band, you
yeah.
know? Then you got a little bit different stuff like Faith No More, you know? And then you got the East Bay, which you would call the East Bay, would be like bands like us, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. A little bit more commercial, but at the same time real heavy, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Well, I want to thank you guys a lot for hanging, freezing in the airport. Hope you make it to your show.
Okay, Ricky.
And maybe we'll get to see you one time when you're not stuck in an airport.
Yeah, man, I hope so.
Okay, thanks a lot, guys.
Okay, take it easy,
Detroit. In the meantime, we're going to have a video from Bonham. He also sent us some drumsticks. People sent us stuff on the desk. I just dropped something off it. And this is Jason Bonham's drumsticks. And here's a new video. This is Guilty. With you here on the Headbangers Law, and of course I hope that you're still with me. And a couple weeks ago I was at the Santa Monica Civic. They were having an anniversary for KNAC, a heavy metal station in California, and I spoke to Mark Torian from the Billet Boys, and this is what he had to say.
Mark, with a Q, Torian from the Billet Boys.
Hello, on TV Land.
Mark, we're going to hear some news. Hi, Mark.
How are you doing, Mark? So we're here.
Oh, yeah, no. We're talking about you anyway. So anyways, you guys are doing some new stuff.
Yes, we are.
Are you done with the new stuff?
We are done writing for our second album, and it will be coming out June the 1st, summertime, when the weather is fine.
And I heard the new album is, what was the one word that you put it?
Freak show.
That wasn't the word. No, that's the title of the album.
Yeah.
Now, what do you mean by the word freak show?
Well,
the word you used before was heavy. You said this new record's going to be heavy.
Oh, when we were talking before? Yeah. It's much heavier than the first album, but it's going to be different. You have to grow, I feel, as a musician, you know. It's going to be the same Bullet Pigs type of thing, you know, but it's going to be a lot more soulful, hopefully.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it's great, man. I'm excited.
Who gave you the idea? Is there a song called Freak Show on it, or?
Yes. Freak Show is basically everything in the entertainment business.
Sounds good. Do you have any ideas when we're going to see a video, or what the first video is going to be?
The first video? I couldn't say it right now, Ricky, really.
No, we'll see it first.
Oh, you will see it first.
You will. Well, thanks a lot, Mark, and we're looking forward to seeing the top. Freak Show. Thanks, all.
You rock the world.
You know, Mark was saying how you have to grow with each album, and it's true, because on the first time, I think he was like 5'8", and I noticed interviewing him, but that was quite stupid. Anyway, also, We're gonna have a debut from Vane. Vane is coming from the Bay Area, San Francisco area. And they played at that same thing I was at the Santa Monica Civic. And here they are to tell us about their new video.
Well, it was shot down here in L.A., and we really like it a lot, you know, because it's sort of set in a little bit of a futuristic mode by a girl in the future that kind of gets off on watching kind of a captivated rock band on this kind of futuristic stage, and it's directed by Jeff Stein, and the guy's a great director, he did a killer job, and you just have to kind of watch it to find out what it's about.
You know, I never knew the guys from Vane until meeting them at that show, and they were really, really cool guys and had some very interesting things to say. And the singer, Dave, doesn't wear shoes and probably has the dirtiest feet in rock and roll. But they're a very good band. And here is their brand new video. Here's Vane with Who's Watching You. Yeah.
guests for this evening are DRI, Spike and Kurt. How you doing?
Pretty good.
I just want to tell you guys that we get a lot of letters about you, so there's a lot of viewers out there that are real happy to see you here. So just want to ask you a question. DRI, the name stands for?
Dirty Rotten Imbeciles.
And are you guys Dirty Rotten Imbeciles?
We'll let you decide.
So if you guys go to the show, it's like up to them, right? If you guys are Dirty Rotten Imbeciles or not. Right. Now, I've seen the drawing, which is kind of that guy, right?
Mm-hmm.
He looks either running or slamming or...
He's slamming. Thrashing.
He's slamming. Just wanted to make sure. Now, on your album, you guys talk about a whole bunch of different stuff. From gun control, the slamming. I think you have a song about Salman Rushdie.
Yeah.
Right.
Kill the words. A lot of social issues.
And what do? You guys just watch the news and kind of... Are you a political band?
To an extent, I would say we are. Mm-hmm. I don't know, we write about things that are worth writing about to us rather than just anything that will go over good.
Mm-hmm.
We like to write about things that are important.
Right. And you guys are currently on the road, right?
Right.
And you're playing right around America?
All over North America and Canada for 10 weeks.
Okay, now we're going to be seeing your video a little bit later and talking to you guys about that. But right now, here's one of my favorite new bands. This is Gothic Slam with Who Died and Made You God. With Dirty Rotten Imbeciles, DRI, Spike and Kurt. And you guys have got a brand new bass player, right?
Right. John Lenoir.
And how did you find him?
We auditioned maybe 30 bass players in San Francisco and Los Angeles. Mm-hmm.
And what are the qualifications to be a Dirty Rotten Imbecile?
Well, it has a lot to do with attitude and stuff like that rather than just musicianship, you know, because we're having problems with bass players, keeping a hold of them, so.
It's got to be someone we can live with almost every day of the year.
Now, I also noticed that you guys all write songs together, right? As opposed to one principal songwriter?
Right.
Is it tough with everybody kind of throwing in ideas, or does it work out good that way?
Good.
It works out good now, I guess. Good mixture.
Now, your latest video, Beneath the Wheel, which we've been showing a real lot on Headbangers Ball, I know a lot of people really like it. It's kind of about a guy not fitting in.
Right.
Is it kind of...
Somebody pressured too hard to succeed in something that they don't want to succeed in.
Mm-hmm. Did you guys kind of help write the video, come up with the idea?
Yeah.
We had a lot to do.
Is it from personal experiences? Like, do you guys have problems, like, at school and stuff like that?
Not too much.
Well, you just saw, like, great A students, right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, well, we're going to see the video from you guys right now. This is DRI with Beneath the Wheel.
Beneath the wheel.
Guys are from San Francisco, right?
They are.
Now, were you there during the big earthquake recently?
Yeah, sure was. Yeah.
Got any good earthquake stories?
Oh, there's a lot of earthquakes there. Uh-huh. That one just lasted a little bit longer. It was a little bit bigger, but we're used to being shaken up there.
Yeah, I know. I live in L.A., so it's kind of used to it.
Yeah.
Did you get any damage or stuff like that to your house?
Yeah, there's damage here and there. It was pretty bad, but we lived through it.
Now, speaking about doing damage, you guys are currently on the road, and you got any wild stories? Because I know the crowds get pretty wild at your shows.
We played Mexico City recently, two nights in Mexico City, which is a pretty big accomplishment for any band, I think, because not that many bands get to play there.
Right. You're always kind of nervous because you really don't know how the crowds are going to react to you until
they're
you get
there. They're real crazy
there. Yeah, real crazy.
Yeah. Now, we've been watching the video Beneath the Wheel on MTV a lot. And you guys have another video in the works?
Abduction.
It's already finished.
So it's done, so we're going to see it real soon, right?
Right.
I hope.
A couple weeks.
Good. You want to give us a little hint about what Abduction's about?
It speaks for itself.
It's self-explanatory. It's just about kids getting abducted and nobody knowing where they're going.
Really? So you guys make songs and videos with a meaning then, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, the song asks a lot of questions like, who are the type of people that abduct kids and what do they do with them and where are the kids and that sort of thing.
Good. Sounds good. Okay, well, thanks a lot for stopping by, and of course we'll be seeing the Abduction video someday soon on Headbangers Ball. In the meantime, here is Lord Tracy out with the boys.